Hello, my name is Caleb, and I'm here today with Rabbia Saeed in the lab of Dr. Todd McDevitt. The research here is studying the mechanical properties of embryonic stem cell spheroids to determine the relationship between stiffness and cell differentiation. So Rabbia, tell me a little bit about why you chose the microsquisher for your testing.
The McDevitt Lab has chosen the microsquisher for our testing because our samples are not tissues, but they're not single cells either. Rather, our samples are micromass aggregates of stem cells. So due to the size and the structure of our aggregates, we can't use instron machines or atomic force microscopy to get the mechanical properties of our samples. However, the microsquisher does have the perfect 50 micron to 20 millimeter scale needed to test our samples.
I know a lot of researchers do different things with the microsquisher, so I wondered if you could just walk us through a typical test setup for your application.
The procedure for setting up the microsquisher for our testing is very simple. Because the microsquisher relies on cantilever mechanics, the first step is to load a cantilever beam into the grip seen here. The grip is then powered by three piezoelectric motors that go in the X, Y, and Z direction, so orient the cantilever. And then our next step is that we use a pipette to transfer one of our samples into the fluid bath. After this, we can then orient the cantilever over the sample with the piezoelectric motors, and we're ready to squish.
Rabbia, can you tell me a little bit more about the test results you're getting and why you find them interesting?
Absolutely. So one of the tests that we acquire is the Force-Displacement curve, or the stress-strain curve, if you normalize the area. So essentially what the microsquisher does is it has a ramp function seen here where you can compress the sample, hold the sample, and then decompress the sample, which is called the recovery phase. And then this sort of test produces a typical stress-strain curve seen here, where you can observe the hysteresis of our viscoelastic samples.
Yeah, as well as doing force displacement tests, I understand you're also doing some stress-relaxation work?
Absolutely. So here you can see a variety of the stress-relaxation curves that we've been acquiring. So the microsquisher applies a unit step at a constant deformation. Here you can see it's approximately 86, 85 micronewtons. And the resulting relaxation of our samples is seen here. There's a peak force and then equilibrium force as our samples relax. The last data type that the microsquisher can acquire is called the creep curve. So we apply a constant force. As you can see, this perfectly applied unit step at 3 micronewtons. And we measure the change in deformation at that constant force.
So I understand you've been using the microsquisher for some time now. Have you been successful in collecting data that has enabled you to learn new and interesting things and start to put together data that's useful in publications?
The McDevitt Lab has had the microsquisher for about a year and a half now, and in that time we already have a publication by Dr. Priya Baraniak that demonstrates how microparticle incorporation stiffens spheroids of mesenchymal stem cells. With the help of the microsquisher, we will certainly have at least one more publication on the mechanical properties of stem cell aggregates in the near future. So stay on the lookout for another McDevitt Lab publication.